Good morning, students. Today we'll discuss the second method of obtaining filters. Let us take FBF filter on a set X. H is a subset of X such that its intersection with every member of filter F is non-empty. And let a collection FH, the collection of all those subsets of X which contains the intersection of H with some member of filter F. Then we claim that this collection is a filter on the set X, and this filter contains the filter F, and also H belongs to this filter. So first of all, we prove that F is contained in the collection FH. So let us take A belonging to the filter F. We have to prove that A belongs to the collection FH. Now, because A contains A intersection H, and by this definition, if a member contains A intersection H for A belonging to filter F, then that member belongs to collection FH. So we can say that A belongs to the collection FH. So A belonging to F implies that A belonging to collection FH. So F is contained in FH. Now, next we claim that this collection is a filter on the set X. Firstly, we show that this collection is non-empty. Now, because this collection FH contains F, and F is filter on the set X, and a filter is non-empty collection of subsets of X, and therefore this collection is also non-empty. Now, next we show that phi does not belong to this collection FH. Let us take B belonging to this collection. So by definition of collection FH, there will exist a member A from the filter F such that B contains A intersection H. Now we are given that A intersection H is non-empty, and this is non-empty, and this is contained in B. So B is non-empty. So we have proved B belonging to this collection implies B is non-empty. So we can say that phi does not belong to the collection FH. Now, in the next condition, let us take a member B belonging to collection FH. K is a subset of X which contains B, and we have to prove that K also belongs to collection FH. Now, because B belongs to this collection, so by definition of this collection, there will exist a member A from the filter F such that B contains H intersection A. Now, B is contained in K. So, combining the two, we can say that A intersection H is contained in K, and therefore by definition K belongs to the collection FH. Now, in the next condition, let us take two members B1 and B2 belonging to the collection FH. Now, by definition of collection FH, there will exist some member A1 and A2 from the filter F such that B1 contains intersection of H with A1, and B2 contains intersection of H with A2. From here, B1 intersection B2 contains A1 intersection A2 intersection H. Now, because A1 and A2 belongs to a filter F, and filter is closed under finite intersections, therefore A1 intersection A2 belongs to the filter F. It means B1 intersection B2 contains the intersection of H with a member of filter F. And therefore, by definition, we can say that B1 intersection B2 belongs to this collection. And therefore, all the conditions for being a filter are satisfied. And therefore, the collection FH is a filter on the set X. And next, we claim that H belongs to this filter. Now, because H is a subset of X, and therefore H intersection X, that will be contained in H. And therefore, by definition, H belongs to the collection FH. So this completes the second method of obtaining a filter. Now, next method of obtaining filters is, if you are having two filters, F and F star, on a set X, and for A belonging to filter F, B belonging to filter F star, A intersection B is non-empty, then the collection F double star, which is the collection of all those subsets of X which contains A intersection B. Here A belongs to filter F and B belongs to filter F star. Then this collection is also a filter on X, and this collection contains both filters F and F star. So firstly, we claim that F and F star are contained in F double star. To prove F is contained in F star, let us take A belonging to the filter F and B belonging to filter F star. Now, because A contains A intersection B, so by this definition, we can say that A belongs to the collection F double star. And this proves that F is contained in F double star. Now, to prove F star is contained in F double star, now again, for B belonging to F star, A intersection B is contained in B. By using this definition, we can say that B belongs to the collection F double star. So this proves that F star is contained in the collection F double star. And from this, because F and F star are filters, they are non-empty collections, so F double star is also non-empty. Now, next we show that phi does not belong to the collection F double star. If we take a member from this collection, by definition of F double star, there will exist a member A from the filter F and a member B from the filter F star, such that A intersection B is contained in H. Now, because A belongs to a filter F and a filter is non-empty because phi does not belong to filter, so we can say A will not be empty. B belongs to F star, F star is a filter, and phi does not belong to any filter, so B is also non-empty. A non-empty, B non-empty. So we have H is also non-empty. Therefore, phi does not belong to collection F double star. Now, in the next condition, let us take K belongs to F double star and H is a subset of X such that H contains K. Now, by using the definition of F double star, because K belongs to F double star, so there will exist a member A from filter F and B from the filter F star, such that A intersection B is containing K. Now K is containing H, so A intersection B will also be contained in H. And therefore, we can say that H belongs to the collection F double star. Now, last condition, let us take two members K1 and K2 belonging to the collection F double star. Again, by using the definition of collection F double star, there will exist a member A1 from filter F and a member B1 from filter F star, such that K1 contains A1 intersection B1. Similarly, for K2 belonging to this filter collection F double star, there will exist a member A2 from filter F and B2 from filter F star, such that K2 contains A2 intersection B2. Here, A2 belongs to the filter F and B2 belongs to the filter F star. Now we can combine these two. So we can say K1 intersection K2 contains A1 intersection A2 intersection B1 intersection B2. Now A1 and A2 belongs to filter F, and filter is closed under finite intersections. Therefore, A1 intersection A2 belongs to F. Also, B1 and B2 belongs to filter F star. Therefore, B1 intersection B2 belongs to F star. So we can say that K1 intersection K2 contains the intersection of member of F and F star. So by definition, K1 intersection K2 belongs to collection F double star. So all the conditions for being a filter are satisfied by this collection. And therefore, we can say that this collection is a filter on the set X. So these were some methods of obtaining filters. Now, next we discuss intersections and unions of filters. So firstly, we show that arbitrary intersection of filters is again a filter. So we are having a non-empty collection denoted by the collection Fi. Here I belongs to index set. This is a non-empty family of filters on a non-empty set X. Then we have to prove that intersection Fi, where I belongs to index set, that is also a filter on X. Let us denote this intersection by F. Now we claim that F is a filter on the set X. Firstly, we show that F is non-empty. Now, because F is the intersection of these Fi's and each Fi in this collection, that is a filter, and X belongs to every filter, so X belongs to their intersection also. And this is F, so we can say that X belongs to collection F. So this collection is non-empty. Next, we show that Phi does not belong to the collection F. Now, because F is the intersection of Fi's and each Fi is a filter on X, and Phi does not belong to any filter, so Phi does not belong to Fi for every I belonging to index set. So Phi cannot be in the intersection, and this is F, so we can say that Phi does not belong to F. In the third condition, let us take F belonging to the intersection of Fi's and H is superset of this F. We have to prove that H belongs to the collection, H belongs to intersection Fi's. Now, because F belongs to intersection Fi's, so by definition, F belongs to Fi for every I belonging to the index set. Now H contains F. Each Fi is a filter for every I belonging to index set. Combining these two, if subset belongs to filter, superset also belongs to filter. So we can say that H belongs to Fi for every I belonging to index set. And therefore, H belongs to intersection Fi's. And therefore, we can say that H belongs to the collection F. In the last condition, let us take two members A and B belonging to intersection Fi. By definition of intersection, it means A belongs to each Fi and also B belongs to each Fi for every I belonging to the index set. Now Fi is a filter, so A intersection B will belong to Fi for every I belonging to index set. And therefore, A intersection B belongs to intersection Fi. And therefore, we can say that A intersection B belongs to the collection F. So this proves that F is a filter on X. Now, next we discuss about union of filters. Union of two filters need not be a filter. Let us see by an example. Let us take a set X containing at least two points X and Y. These are two distinct points. And let us take the point filters generated by X and Y. Point filter generated by X is denoted by X dot. And by definition, X dot is the collection of all those subsets of X which contains X. Y dot is the collection of all those B subset of X which contains the point Y. These two are the filters on the set X. Let us denote this filter by F1 and this filter by F2. Now we claim that their union is not a filter. Now because X belongs to singleton X and by definition of X dot, the set which contains the point X belongs to this filter. Therefore, we can say that singleton X belongs to filter F1. In the same way, Y belongs to singleton Y and the sets which contains the point Y, they belong to filter F2. So, singleton Y belongs to filter F2. Now, from here we can say that singleton X belongs to F1 union F2 and singleton Y belongs to F1 union F2. Now we show that F1 union F2 is not a filter. If we consider this union is a filter, then singleton X intersection singleton Y, that should also belong to this filter because a filter is closed under finite intersections. But X and Y are distinct points. So singleton X intersection singleton Y, that is Phi. It means Phi belongs to this union. But this is a contradiction because Phi does not belong to any filter. So this contradiction proves that F1 union F2 is not a filter. So this proves that union of two filters need not be a filter.